You have a 12-year-old child that was killed under incredibly tragic circumstances that could have been avoided.
Attorney Subodh Chandra, who represents the Tamir Rice family, told Fox 8 Monday that the $6 million settlement in the Tamir Rice case does not bring closure to the 12-year-old's family.
There's no sense of justice, but it is a conclusion to the civil process.
The settlement was reached Monday. The city states they are paying without admitting that anyone did anything wrong in the death of Tamir Rice.
At the end of the day, a 12-year-old child lost their life. And that should not have happened in the city of Cleveland. It should not have happened.
Tamir Rice was shot and killed by a Cleveland police officer in November 2014. Police thought Tamir had a real gun. He had an airsoft pistol that police said looked like a real gun. In December, a grand jury declined to indict Officer Timothy Lohman and his partner, Frank Garmbach. Jurors concluded that it was a perfect storm of human error, but not a criminal act. The officers thought Tamir was waving around a real gun. He was not.
And while I know this does not bring total relief to that family, it at least sends a signal that this kind of behavior is totally unacceptable and is not going to be condoned by people of reasonable minds.
Mike Nelson, president of the NAACP, says he believes it is now time to make positive changes in the police department, something Tamir Rice's family also wants.
It's incredibly important to the family of Tamir Rice and to the mother of Tamir Rice that, you know, Tamir not have died in vain and for no purpose. It's incredibly important to that family that there be change in the policing of the city of Cleveland, in other police departments, that people not, you know, fire immediately.
Police union president Steve Loomis said the Tamir Rice shooting is an absolute tragedy for the Rice family, as well as the officers involved and their families.